Can I upgrade this though? Ooh. 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 Okay. Hello, who is watching? I'm really just upgrading my stuff right now. So I am going to be actually playing the game in a second. Should I finish getting these upgrades first? Thank you.
truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. He won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
I see something down there.
Correct.
I see by the subtitle.
There shouldn't be a subtitle.
You want to be here?
Is that a fruit?
No, Seth.
Why are we not just like... like, what's so amusing about it? You caught this before? Have you got it before?
Yeah.
They need to make, like, things that, they need to make parties. They need to make parties. They need to make parties.
They're there. Oh, sorry, we forgot to take that off your bed. Nah, I'm joking. Voldemir, mine.
Here, boy.
Wonder who wrote this.
That alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If you're smart, you'll find him.
So, Rock said his father was a dwarven like him, wearing a green ring.
Look if you wish. I will be gathering resources for our journey.
Boot MOG face with tongue.
No help, afterlife.
It does not attack.
Ah. Mom made them sound more dangerous than that.
Then do not drop your guard. Come.
Guess who's back again?
Tell a friend. Yeah.
Here we go.
Nobody's so mystic.
Man, look like.
Yeah.
I can barely hear you.
I don't know why you can hear me. It's pretty weird. You can hear me pretty well. Good job, boy.
Soul Eater got him. Must have been part of that Asmus thing.
Speak up, boy.
I am talking, and I'm talking pretty loud. So I don't know what you're talking about.
Talk louder then.
I'm talking louder when I'm in your pit.
Then. Anyways, have fun. You never took my advice, by the way. I will prop send a friend the link to the stream. Have fun.
Okay.
Look here.
Sir. Another map. Bet we'll find something useful here.
This bitch can climb walls. Yeah, he can't fucking do that by himself. Ha!
Interesting.
Severed hand
attached to the Soul Eater.
Well, we know what happened to Invari now. We can just go tell Brock. No need to fight it, right?
You fight it.
But why?
Because you are frightened of it. Strong, Atreus. Stay focused and look for a weak point.
Yes, sir.
Stay quiet. Make no sudden movement. Focus up!
What? Yeah, I think so too.
and look for a weak point.
Yes, sir. It was a massacre.
You scare up that alchemist, what needed finding? See you next, whereas I see you.
These runes read death inside.
Stay quiet. Make no sudden movement.
Let's go.
than you know. Dwarvish inscription.
The alchemist. But where's the rest of it?
Ashes, most likely.
The Soul Eater got it. I guess we should bring it back to Brock.
Comments from the same bitch. That's impressive for one bitch.
What does it say?
Yes, sir. These runes were written fast. It spells out Ejim Staney. I don't know that one.
We will ask the blue one.
So now you're interested?
We found his alchemist. A reward was promised.
Roger, behind you!
That was accidentally...
Goop emoji face with tongue. Skipping.
Atreus, to me!
Okay, coming!
What'd you find?
Your alchemist.
I'm sorry, Brock. The hand is all we could find. Still wearing the ring. There was a Soul Eater inside. And, well, we must have burned away the rest of him.
Suppose you'll still be wanting some compensation, huh?
Naturally.
Naturally, he says. Miani Feruxi.
Ooh.
Now take a closer look at this here ring. Maybe Anvari left a bit of magic inside before he croaked.
Dwarves can do that?
Sure, dwarves and magic jewels is like flies and pig lips. Supple ones.
Ugh. I'm not as interested as I thought.
Oh, there. Got...
What do you want, dwarf?
I got another lead on my old pal Anvari. Meet me at the Lawnsoother Mines. There's some fancy-dancy loot in it for you.
Another lead? But we already found him. Well, found his hand anyways.
I'll explain at the mines. These ones is just south of the river pass. Now you two want something, or you just gonna stand there all gag-scrapped and slack-jawed? Pulled the ring off on Vari's hand at the Velander mines. Feller was always tampering with souls and dark rituals and matters of the night, see? Just the sound of his hammer flattening metal were enough to stoke my fires all blissful. Shit, you better clear out before I get all frisky.
Come.
Come.
Hmm. Come.
The Unity Stone, didn't it? I wanted to fly again.
Yes, that's a terrible pity.
Okay, tell me again how Odin knew we were going to Jotunheim before we did.
Odin is extremely clever, you see. Nearly as clever as he thinks he is. And he's a collector of prophecies. If it's about the future, he adds it to his collection. Helps him style himself as all-seeing and all-knowing. But of course, the idea is control. Control of the future, control of his fate. He'd control every realm of every land in every world if he could. Every potential pocket of resistance, he seeks to eliminate. Even if you've never posed a threat before, he may think one day you might. So you see, it's not important how he knew before you did. It's important that he was right.
Got you all bum-fuzzled over there. Get going!
Better not be fighting with your brother again.
Just because he's gotten a little less annoying over the years doesn't mean I ain't got a customer base of my own to keep happy.
Oh, yeah? Who's that?
Well, you came back here, didn't you?
Fair point.
Go ahead and lock in Jotunheim and we'll be on our way. Probably.
I finally ordered boys bunk bed because I got my tax returns. So. Until it gets.
Boy, go ahead. Get ready.
Oh.
Right. Got it. Let's hope this doesn't cause you to explode or anything.
Oh, hadn't considered that. Maybe we should talk about this a bit more.
Nah, I'm sure you'll be fine. Ready?
That's unpleasant!
Now, boy!
A word, please, before we continue. Listen, the last thing you two need up there is a decomposing heat ruin in the moment. Why don't I wait for you here? This is between you and the boy.
True. But if someone were to fight...
My Lady Sif's soft, perfect slashers. You done did it.
Sorry. We had to see this.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. Fine, damn it. Fine.
Watch the head till we return.
I can do this. No, no, I can't.
Oh. Okay.
Ready. Come.
Look! We're on the giant's fingers. I can see the highest peak ahead. Right over there. We did it.
We did.
What are you doing?
I have nothing more to hide.
Can we go now? We're so close.
Boy.
It's nothing. I just thought I'd hear voices by now. Hello? Anybody here?
Who is this place?
They must have all come through here when they left Midgard. What was left of them.
Why carve all these faces?
What if this is all the giants that got out of Midgard alive? Not really many at all. Odin and Thor, ruining everything for everybody.
Where are they now?
The giants came back home so they could survive. But I'm not sure they did. Huh. Who's the guardian? I should feel them, but I don't. This place is dead. What happened to them? Why'd Mom send us here?
One question is answered, and two more take its place.
Wait! Father! Something's happening! Your axe. It's Muller. Look. She's arguing with a bunch of giants. She knew giants? That's us. The first time we met the world serpent. But how? And our fight with Baldur. But that just happened. Wait. They knew everything that was going to happen. The dragon in the mountain. The stone mason. All these drawings. This is our story.
No. This is your story.
But what does it all mean?
That I was not the only parent with secrets.
You didn't know. She was a giant.
Oh, he's part giant.
I'm a giant. Why didn't she tell us?
She sent us here knowing we would find this.
But why not just tell us the truth?
Your mother would have had good reasons. Baldur was never sent to find me. He was tracking her all along, not knowing she was only ashes.
If she had a plan for us, I trust it. Whatever it is. Besides, she hasn't been wrong yet. Come on. We're so close to the end now.
Yes. Yes, we are.
Look, it's Mother's. She was here. She saw every step we took before we took it. Like she was always with us. Watching over us. Leading us home. Let's finish it.
Oh! son. Goodbye, Faye.
I love you, Mom. The Giants. They really are all gone. There's nothing for us here.
Come.
So, I get that Mother was a giant. Which makes me part giant and part god.
And part mortal.
Right. I guess there's just one thing I don't understand.
Partially my bed, actually.
No, it isn't.
The giants called me...
Okay, they're mattress. Everything else on here, what you're sitting on, what you're using...
Okay.
Not what you're using, what you're sitting on.
What's the name your mother wanted for you when you were born? She must have called you that to her people.
But why?
A question for another day. Let us go home.
It all makes sense now. Why she want to end up here? Be with her kind? But did she know it was going to be like this here? Is this what she wanted us to see? Did she want us to tell the people? Or keep it a secret?
I do not know.
So what should we do?
I trust you to decide that.
Oh. So why'd you want to name me Atreus? I know it can't be for a god.
No. He was a soldier. A Spartan.
A great warrior?
All Spartans are great warriors. We trained from birth. Our lives were discipline, duty, battle, and death. Life was grim, and we greeted it grimly. But Atreus of Sparta was unlike the rest of us. He wore a smile even in the worst of times. He was happy. He inspired us to hope. That though we were machines of war, yet there was humanity in us. Goodness. When the day came for him to lay down his life in battle, his sacrifice saved countless others and turned the tide in our favor. I carried him home on his shield and buried him with all the honors of Spartan custom. His memory was a comfort in dark times.
Wow, you actually told a good story. Amir missed it. I understand if you want to go home, but I bet there are still some corrupted Valkyries out there that could be set free. Some other helping people. Maybe helping people is part of why Mom sent us out here, too. I mean, what would Atreus of Sparta do?
And what would Loki do?
Huh. That's a weird name. I'm glad we went with yours.
Lads, am I glad to see you.
I believe
believe I've reached my limit for dwarven charm.
What happened, Mimir?
They took an uncomfortable number of measurements and then proceeded to bicker about the weather.
Where do you want us to take you?
How about the warm confines of anywhere bloody else? Before we return to Midgard, I should warn you. More time has passed than you might realize. The snowfall that began when you slew Baldur has become something else. Stuff of omens.
Omens for the coming of winter.
Not just any winter, but a great winter to span three summers. And when it's done, Ragnarok.
Ragnarok from snow.
Aye, snow. Lots more snow. And then the end of the bloody world, in that approximate order.
Another prophecy.
No, brother. Prophecy doesn't expect this for 100 more winters at least. You've changed something. Prophecy didn't count on you.
I'm telling you, it's Fimbul winter. I can feel it in my throat. This is the big one.
Stop saying that. Oh, you're making me very nervous. It was bound to snow sooner or later.
That ain't just snow, and you know it. It's the end times.
How dare you make me the voice?
Guys?
Just discussing the weather. Bit of a cold snap lately.
What he means is, Fimbul winter's upon us, boys. The winter to end all winters. I can feel it in my throat.
Yeah. We heard.
So, if you're heading home, try to keep moving. And also, to not die.
Or if you're not heading home, same advice.
Down there. Okay. Obviously the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Frey end up a hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough. Freya was better to him than he deserved. She stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people. And we'll pick this up later.
Oh.
You were telling us how Frey ended up living in the woods.
Aye, she'd married Odin. But Odin's madness, his tyranny, his corruption of her magics, it became more than she could stomach, and at long last she broke it off. Odin's wrath was fierce, and his curses upon her were more than she dared to fear.
But your magic was so much stronger than hers.
After so much time together, he knew her vulnerabilities, and exploited them to craft curses she could never break.
Oh, like not being able to leave Midgard.
Worse still, he robbed her of her warrior spirit. Freya cannot fight, even to defend herself. No living thing may she harm by blade nor spell. In a world this belligerent, what choice does she have but isolation?
Poor Freya. I guess if I was her, I'd spit in your face too.
I lied. Die.
Quite a formidable duo.
Boy, over here.
Yes, sir. Okay, that's going in the journal.
You
I hated that ending, so I'm just gonna continue.
Another name. Gunnar.
Another Valkyrie. Some coincidence. That could have edged them on Tyr's braziers.
Thank you.
Amir, what else did the serpent tell you when you spoke? Kinda sounded important.
I'm sure it's nothing. He just said the boy seemed familiar to him.
Me? That's impossible.
Don't I quite agree? Unless, perhaps, he refers to something yet to be. It is said that when Jormungandr and Thor battle at Ragnarok, their clash so violently shakes the Tree of Life that it splinters, casting the serpent backward through time, even before his own birth.
That is madness.
Well, I did say not to concern yourself.
We're finally home. Feels like a lifetime ago.
Bit drafty, maybe. It's a right improvement over having tree bark in your tadger.
Prepare yourself!
Thank you.
Ready yourself!
Yep. Exactly what I told him.
He's next to Mother's garden this whole time.
No one.
No wonder we can never get him there.
Did you find a mattress? It's Mom's bed.
I was about to say that means it's Mom's bed. So shut up.
Who uses it? Who uses it every day?
Both of us.
Who uses it every night to go to sleep?
You said every day, not every night.
Desperate to find a way into Yomar.
He's convinced the giants hold the key to changing his fate when Ragnarok comes. They are the Aesir's oldest enemies, after all. And it's their army that's supposed to do him in the end. But more than that, he covets their gifts of prophecy. He wants to know what they know and see what they see. So much suffering could have been avoided if his insatiable curiosity was not so much stronger than his wisdom.
What do you mean?
Ah, remind me to tell you why they call him the Lord of the Hanged.
Look here.
Sir. Wonder who wrote this.
Hey,
What? Okay.